We take care of the water for our children that are coming behind us. We have children in front that went. We have children now in the present. Our Grand Chief, Eddie Benton Benet from the Medewin Lodge in Wisconsin, he was here a couple of weeks ago. And we put together a water bundle to feed the water with that bear meat and that sturgeon, corn, rice, and strawberries. Then we had a big feast after. And we let this bundle go in between Christian Island. We call it Che Namem Nising and Cedar Point. And all of us women went down and we went and put that water bundle in there so that we can have pure, clean water for the next seven generations behind us. And that's what we believe in as Medewin people. So I want to say welcome and Jimmy Gwich for inviting me to come here tonight and speak about the water. This is my life road, my life path that I have chosen to walk and take care of that water bundle and take care of those water teachings.
Oh, okay.
Site 41. It's always a thrill to be up here. It's so great to see so many faces that that you know we saw smudged with sage. Thank you. Smudged with sage and blessed by the sunshine and rained on and frozen out and chased by cops and victorious finally in the end. And that's all it is. So this is our sixth stop on the Great Lakes Need Great Friends tour. It's all about the Great Lakes, and it's all about tonight. There's going to be a little bit about Site 41 as well, as you can imagine, because Site 41 was definitely a threat to the Great Lakes, and the Great Lakes are threatened by so many other things at the moment. You're going to hear a lot about that tonight, and you're also going to hear about what you can do. So I'd also like to introduce to you, first of all, Emma Louie. She is our Great Lakes campaigner for the Council of Canadians, our water campaigner.
Thank you very much. As I mentioned, my name is Emma, and I'm thrilled to be here. I've heard great. I came to the Council of Canadians shortly after the victory at Site 41, but I've heard lots of great things, so very happy to be here. And for those of you who don't know, I'll just talk a little bit about the Council of Canadians. We're Canada's largest advocacy organization. We've got 75,000 members across Canada and about 70 chapters also across Canada. And our mandate is quite simple. It's to empower ordinary people with a powerful collective voice to hold governments and corporations accountable to the public interest and to social and environmental justice. And we do this by developing accessible public education materials, mobilizing public pressure around key issues.
That said, I'd like to welcome you all to the Township of Tiny Again, Ontario's very first blue community, and for that distinction we owe Maude our deep thanks and the Council of Canadians as well.
Well, Ray Miller, congratulations for being the first blue community in Ontario. All the best. best wishes and keep our place green and the water pristine. Thank you.
We'll do our very best.
There we go. This is from the Simcoe chapter of the Council of Canadians to hang in your offices so that people won't forget. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you very much, Maude. This evening, Maude and the rest of our panel are going to speak to us about some of the abuses and neglect our Great Lakes have suffered over the years, and they're going to impress upon us the urgent need and the ongoing need for us to become more involved and engaged with what's happening in our Great Lakes systems. Here in our neck of the woods, we're able to tell a bit of a success story, but at the same time, we continue to recognize that there's a need to be ever vigilant. Of course, I'm speaking about Severn Sound more specifically. Severn Sound, as many of you know, is a group of bays covering an area of about 130 square kilometers, located here in southeastern Georgian Bay. The immediate watershed of our area covers an area of approximately 1,000 square kilometers, so all the tributaries drain from 1,000 kilometers into our region here. In Severn Sound, we've been able to form an effective partnership that I think is the very key to the environmental conservation and protection benefits that we've been able to recognize here over the past several years. We rely on these partnerships with our neighboring municipalities, our service organizations, and individuals to raise awareness and to bring attention to conservation and environmental stewardship targets. In 1985, Severn Sound was one of 17 places on the Canadian side of the Great Lakes that had been identified as an area of concern because of degraded water quality. In fact, we were one of the worst polluted areas that had been identified. In each area of concern, a remedial action plan had been developed. It was to control the source of pollution and to report on cleanup efforts. Between 1987 and 2003, Environment Canada and the Ontario Ministry of the Environment were working with other federal and provincial agencies and local stakeholders in the Severn Sound area to complete this remedial action plan. As part of the plan, and in accordance with the International Great Lakes Water Quality Agreement, we committed to reporting on our progress and on our action plan in three various stages. The first stage was to describe the environmental conditions and to prepare a problem definition statement. Now that may seem not significant to many, but I can assure you that half the battle is identifying what the problem is, and that's something that we learned in the Site 41 issue as well. In turn has led to significant improvement in the water quality of Severn Sound. And in 2003, the restoration targets had been met and Severn Sound was delisted as an area of concern. So I think that's a great achievement on our part.
I don't think so. I heard gentle words from the county. However, to me, the focus from the county.
It looks so good on his arm, eh?
Oh, stop. Come on.
You can pick my purse up and hold it for me.
Just
follow me around and hold it for me.
I'm very fortunate to share the stage with Ray Miller and Mary Muter and Maude Barlow. I cannot say enough good things about the Council of Canadians, and I ask humbly from my heart that everybody supports and advocates for the Council of Canadians and the work that they're doing because it's so important. It's not only important to the Great Lakes, it's important to who we are as human beings. It's important for us to be responsible citizens and engage and become informed and learn about not only our, the water, but our connection to Mother Earth. We see all these technical things that Mary has. She's got such a great brain on her. But all of the different legislation and everything that kind of sometimes can seem overwhelming at times. And a lot of hours and research go into learning all of this and being able to provide it to one another. And in that process, we must not forget to remember the spirit. Because if you guys remember at Site 41, that spirit and that science went hand in hand.
Right.
They complement each other. They need to go hand in hand with every single movement that happens now for water, for the right to live as human beings all over the world. For everything that we do in our lives, we must recognize and honor both. And when I gave an interview today to Liz, I was very adamant to stress the fact that when we got together as First Nations people and non-Native communities, it was that diversity and the beauty of that diversity that had come together to make that happen. And what is it that the knowledge that you guys brought was that science through Steve, a lot of the time, through Bill Shotta, through the research of the Council of Canadians, through the research of Georgian Bay Forever, through Mary Muter. David Black was there. The first time ever we had had a Madewan ceremony and a United Church ceremony. Ever in my life have I seen that. So no matter where we go and what we do, when we're thinking about the Great Lakes, we must always remember the spirit of everything, the spirit of this land. My aunt spoke to you, and I'm so thankful to have my aunt. She was at Site 41. She walked with us. She did a water ceremony the very first day of the water walk at the fill station in Allenville. We were sitting there. Nobody knew that we were there, but we were over there doing a water ceremony. People were coming by thinking, what are you doing? And I was with Beth at that time. And we did that full moon ceremony. And it was through my aunt and my uncle that sacred fire was lit. And that sacred fire was really the pinnacle of strength for a lot of people. So when we're looking at the Great Lakes, the Anishinaabe women, all over Turtle Island, and that includes the United States as well. We are unified as Anishinaabe people. There are no borders that will take away who we are. And those are allies within the states as well, when we look at that. And Maude has worked with Josephine Mondawmin previously. And Maude has probably been, I wish more politicians were like Maude. Actually. Because she has been always so very, very respectful and open to our culture and understanding what it is that the Anishinaabe women do. And what we do is we care for the spirit of that water. Those are the teachings that led us through Site 41. Those are the teachings that will carry us through saving the Great Lakes. Those are the teachings that will carry us through saving water all over Canada and the United States. And I cannot stand up here and say, without saying anything about Lake Simcoe as well,
right,
which is in dire need of help and support.
Mm-hmm.
So there are water battles all over Tiny Township, Midland Penetanguishene, Central Ontario, all over Ontario, all over the world right now.
The Melancton Quarry.
And when we offer our water in the morning, or whenever it is that we drink it, I ask you to remember those ones who don't have water when you're drinking it. Because one of the things that we've lost as human beings is the sacredness of all things.
Yeah.
We take for granted so much. And in our Anishinaabe teachings, we only take what we need. and as a collective human body, and I'm not, just because I'm Anishinaabe does not mean I am free of sin, but myself too I have overused. But there is a water footprint associated with every single action that we do. So when we're drinking our water, to remember those ones who are going without water, or who have to walk 50 miles a day to get it. Little children on the other side of the world. Even Anishinaabe here in Ontario, who do not have water.
That's right.
Other communities as well, who do not have access to water. So that's about as much as I want to say, and I want to thank you all again, and it's such an honor to be here and to see all of you. And I hope we come together again more often.